for you to be here. Smile. Outside it's sunny. Yesterday it was windy. It's a little less so today. It's going to be in the 70s all week. It's going to be cool. In the 60s, less than the 60s. But we can still thank God. He blesses us here. Now it's time for the purpose of worshiping God and praising the Lord. Let's sing together this morning from our hearts, praises to the Lord in song. We remember him. Wow, Lord God, I'm surprised so much. Think all things your hands have made. I see the stars, I hear much thunder. Your power above the world shows. In my soul, my Savior God, wow, you are so wonderful. You are truly wonderful. In my soul, my Savior God, wow, you are so wonderful. You are truly wonderful. Heavens, I thank God you gave us your Son. Jesus came to die. I can't understand. On the cross, Jesus was happy to accept my sin. He bled and died to take away my sin. In my soul, my Savior God, wow, you are so wonderful. You are truly wonderful. In my soul, my Savior God, wow, you are so wonderful. You are so truly wonderful. In the future, Christ will come with an announced victory and carry you there. It truly inspires my heart. Then I bow in humble worship, there to announce, my God, you are so wonderful, wow. In my soul, my Savior, God, wow, you are so wonderful, you are truly wonderful. In my soul, my Savior, God, wow, you are so wonderful. You are so wonderful. Many, many years ago, Jesus went to the cross, and that was so wonderful. We praise the Lord. We continue to praise him. He is always there. He never ends. His work continues. Unfailing. Unfailing God. You see this picture? It's a rock. Fail and never fail. Do you fail? Or never fail. Anyone hates to fail in some things. We don't like to fail. Sometimes we fail and we get frustrated or depressed or disappointed. For example, this morning getting up and getting dressed and eating breakfast and coffee, I'm finished and I'm ready to go to church or ready to go to work. And the car doesn't start. The car fails. It doesn't work. It won't start. But it's time to go to work. I'm going to be late. I don't like that. Or children. It's time for children to go to school. They have a test on that day. They answer the test and they get a failing grade. Then they're upset and depressed. There are different ways to fail. In cooking, measuring all your ingredients, and you take it out of the oven and it tastes awful. You failed to add something. You missed something. Who never fails in life? Who's perfect? Who never fails? That's impossible. All of us fail. If we fail, we become downhearted. Do we give up? No, we try again. The car may not start, does not work. We fix it, or it could be the starter or some part. We fix it and then we can drive it again. Cooking, don't do it right. Don't give up, no. Just try again. Cook it again. This time it's right and it tastes better. School, we fail a test, study. And it improves. Maybe they get a C. There was a story, there's a quote. There was a person who said this. It was Albert Einstein. He was a famous scientist. Albert Einstein. He said, if you have never failed, you've never tried anything new. And this is right. If we didn't fail, if we were perfect, we wouldn't learn anything. We wouldn't try anything new. I fail and I accept that. I fail, I don't give up. I try again and I learn. Jared Leto said, try and fail, but never fail to try. Try again and again and again, and you'll be successful. You'll make it. We always fail at something. It's not possible to never fail. The most important question, does our spiritual life fail? Our life to God, our living. On earth we can fail or be successful, but with God, with our spiritual life, do we fail with God? Maybe you know or you feel like you have truly failed. That something's not right with God in your life. And you know the truth, but you fail to follow Him. Or sometimes you fail. Some things are right, you have to change them. Or you never fail in life, your spiritual life. Everything is perfect. Is it? In ministry, sometimes people fail. Is failing bad? No, failing is normal. We learn and improve from our failures. We learn. We know wrong from right. We know when we do wrong that we failed and that we weren't successful. We learn what God wants us to learn. And we know, and we acknowledge our sorrow for our wrong. He helps us to learn when we are stay close to Him. The first important things to do when we fail in life, what do? Make sure to check your life with God. Check. Make sure everything is right and that you change the wrongs. Find the reason that you failed. Was it your attitude? Don't let your spiritual life fail. Don't continue. Don't give up. Don't just stop. Sometimes we do fail, but we need to continue with the Lord. He helps us and we pray. What do we do? Everyone looks at God's word through Jesus Christ. And Jesus never failed. He never failed. We fail often. We fail and fail with sin. But He, God, never fails. We look to God through Jesus Christ. These verses, we're going to begin with Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 5, unfailing things of God. There are two translations we will look at, the New King James Version, the Lord is righteous, He is in her midst. He is there in Jerusalem. He will do no unrighteousness. This means that He will do no wrong. Every morning, He brings His justice. This means His help to light. He, God, never fails. But the unjust or the bad people know no shame. Let's compare it with EBD, the English version for the deaf. It's the same verse, but God is still in that city. He was still there in Jerusalem. And He continues to be good. God does not do anything wrong. He continues to help His people. Morning after morning, He helps His people make good decisions. But those bad people are not ashamed of the bad things they do. God never fails. He helps people. He helps us. People often think that God fails, but He helps us with whatever we need. They have problems. Maybe their health is bad. Maybe things happen. They say, God didn't help me. He failed. This is not true. God helps us. God knows our bodies and our lives and our problems, and He will help our souls to be strong in the Lord. I'm going to try this list of what things doesn't the Lord fail. He does the unfailing presence of the Lord. Presence. Face to face with God. The Lord is always with the people who believe Him. In the Old Testament time and the New Testament time and today, He still is with us, with the people who believe Him. Always with us. Jesus Christ is with us too, through the Holy Spirit. He leads us. The Holy Spirit is in you, and you are connected to God. You are children of His. God is our Father, and He is with us always. He is with everyone, all of us. This verse in the Old Testament in Deuteronomy 31, 6 and 8, in the time of Moses, it was near time for Moses' life to end. And he was talking about when Moses died, Joshua would be the leader of the people of Israel. Be strong and be brave. Don't be afraid of those people, because the Lord your God is with you. He will not fail you or leave you. Again, verse 8. The Lord will lead you. He himself, this was Joshua, he himself is with you. He will not fail you or leave you. Don't worry. Don't be afraid. Strong and comforting, he will be with you. Joshua was burdened. There were thousands of people that he was responsible for. He was strong and brave. In Joshua 1:5, after Moses had died, and Joshua became the leader, again, the word was emphasized. Just as I was with Moses, I will be with you. And this was God. No one will be able to stop you all your life. I will not abandon, will not give up or leave you. I will never leave you. God himself was unfailing with Joshua. Joshua followed him and he obeyed God. And there are many verses in the Old Testament and today that God is with us. He never fails. And so we praise the Lord and we thank him. The Lord never fails you. The Lord doesn't forget you and doesn't leave you. The Old Testament and New Testament, it's the same. Hebrews 13:5. God has said, I will never leave you. I will never run away from you. I will never leave you. Do you fail God and Jesus? Do you forget the Lord? Do you leave him? Some people do, not all people. They fail God. They fail to follow what he wants them to do. They forget. They're busy. They don't think about the Lord. They're overwhelmed with their busy life. Or they turn to the world and forget about God. They stray away. We need to test our hearts and see. And if we've strayed away, come back to the Lord. He will help us. We can come back to him and he will forgive us. The unfailing faithfulness of the Lord. The Lord created us to live with his power. Wow. From the beginning, he made the world, the whole earth, made Adam and Eve, and still he is with us. He made us his. We are born, and we are his. It was his design for the people. And he is faithful to us. He doesn't forget us. That shows his faithfulness to us, to the world. What? We have the air to breathe, the sun, the rain, the water, the animals, all these different things. Why? Because God is faithful to us. He knows that we need these for life. Psalms 89:3. We need the sun, the rain. He takes care of us. He says, I will not allow my faithfulness to fail. He doesn't allow that. God is faithful, always. He never fails. Imagine if the Lord's faithfulness, it wouldn't be possible. The world would be gone. The world has continued because God is there and He is faithful to the world. We look up to Him and we praise Him for the stars, the sun, and the moon. The Lord is never failing. He continues to believe us. He is kind and loving to us. He is patient. He waits for everyone to repent and obey the gospel. He knows the world is there and we have problems. Many things happen. He knows that we have sin on earth. And He lets us decide if we will follow Him or follow the world. He lets us choose. And He is patient, waiting for us to choose and repent and obey the gospel, to be baptized into Christ and to live from then on following Him. In 2 Timothy 2:13, Paul was writing, if we are not faithful, God will still be faithful. He doesn't ignore us, but He's faithful to the people. He doesn't ignore the people. Because He cannot be false to Himself. He shows that He is true and that He truly cares. And He is faithful to the people. He is patient with us. We are weak and we often don't understand. But we can turn to the Lord and be faithful to the Lord because He loves us. Do you continue faithfulness to God? Do you continue? The world is tempting us through what we see, through technology, through many different things. The world tempts us and causes us to be weak in our faith to God. The Bible verses themselves encourage us to be faithful. A few times Jesus, when He was living on earth, He told His followers a few times, He said, O ye of little faith. We're like that. We don't have enough faith. Sometimes we're weak in our faith. We need to be strong and improve our faith in the Lord. And Jesus prayed in Luke 22:32. And Jesus, He said, but I have prayed for you that your faith should not fail. Jesus knew that our faith would fail. He knew and He prayed that we would keep the faith and we would keep faithful. He knew the world would try to destroy our faith and that we needed to seek His word to help us keep our faith. And this is interesting. The unfailing Son of God. Jesus most of you know the story of Jesus' life. All over the world, people know that Jesus was born from the Virgin Mary, and he grew, and he ministered and served, and he had wonderful power to heal people. They arrested him, and they beat him, and put him on a cross. And then 3 days later, he rose again. In Hebrews 1:12 in the EVD, God said to Christ, "You will fold them like a coat, and they will be changed like clothes. But you, Jesus, never change, and your life will never end." Your life will never end, never fail. He came, he was born, he died. Did Jesus fail in life? Jesus, so never fail. He was born, he died, he was killed, and he rose again. And he lives forever. Hebrews 13:8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He is the same. Forever. He never fails. He continues. During the end, Christ's life on the cross, he cried out with a loud voice saying, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani." These words are translated, my God, why have you left me alone?" God left him, and it became dark when God left because of sin. He never failed. Did he fail? Did God or Jesus fail? He died on the cross. Jesus died on the cross. No. This was planned. This would happen from the Old Testament prophecies to many years later. Jesus on the cross, his suffering and his death. God left him because of sin. Not Jesus' sin, but our sin. He collected the sins of the whole world, and they were put on him on the cross, the sins of the whole world. Wow. He had no wrong, but this was on purpose. After 3 days, God raised Christ from the dead. He's never failing. He had the power to raise him. If we die, do we fail? No. Our souls will be raised with the Lord. We can believe and trust the true Jesus Christ, our Savior. He never fails. Do you fail to follow Christ? We know he's the Son of God, but we must follow Christ. We have a lot of pressure in the world, and a lot of things are wrong with us, but we still follow Christ. We can try to follow Christ, and we can learn from Christ's life and his example. We see his suffering, and we follow God. We follow him. We obey everything. Christ died on the cross, and we give glory to the Lord. We follow Christ. We learn. Sometimes we fail and we forget our behavior and our attitude. that we remember Jesus Christ and we follow Christ's life. The unfailing promise of the Lord. The Lord never fails his promise from beginning of time to now, to the future. His promises are never failing. Things happen. In Joshua 23:14, it was near time. Joshua was old. It was near time for him to die. It is almost time for me to die. You know, he was talking to the people, the Israelites, you know, and truly believe that the Lord has done many great things for you. You know that he has not failed in any of his promises. The Lord has kept every promise that he has made to us. He's kept all of his promises. He's never failing. Short term, he's kept his promises. Long term, for example, Noah, he told Noah that a flood would come, and Noah built the boat, the ark, and it took Noah a long time, many, many years, nothing happened. Over 100 years, Noah built the boat. He wasn't yet 100 years old, imagine. Often people make promises. Abraham, God had told him he would be the father of many nations, and he was 100 years old when finally his son was born. And Sarah was 90. And there began his faithfulness. The promised land. Moses was leading his people out of Egypt to the promised land, but they had to wander for 40 years. God wanted to make sure they would be faithful and trust him. Sometimes they complained and they weren't faithful, and things happened, and they didn't trust the Lord. Sometimes we look to the promised land, which is heaven. We must stay faithful, and we will reach heaven. The promise of salvation in our lives. We'll die, yes, but our soul will be saved with the Lord. We will always be with the Lord. The promise of eternal life. In the future, when we die, he will take us there with him. We look. Life on earth is short. 2 Peter 3:9. The Lord is not slow about his promise, as some people count slowness. Many years, people want him to hurry. They can't be patient. People die and things happen. They think Jesus should come. He promised, but he hasn't yet come. And people complain. They think it takes too long. But he is patient toward you, not willing for any to be lost, but for all to come to repentance. He wants all to repent. He's not in a hurry to destroy the earth and lose so many souls. Some have not yet repented. He wants more. He is patient. Do you fail in your promises for your life to the Lord? Do you fail? Sometimes we do fail. We fail to read, or we fail to pray, or we fail to go to meetings. In assembly together to worship the Lord. I will do many things what I can do my best. We're warned not to use the word promise. Remember, don't say any promise in the name of the Lord. Why? Because we fail so often. God never fails in His promises. He is the only one that can promise. We say we will do our best. We will do our best to read and pray as often as we can and go to meetings. I promise I'll go to meetings. Maybe I get sick. Don't use the word promise, because something might happen and you can't follow that promise. That's sinning against God. If you make a promise, you must keep it. Just say, I will do my best to go to meetings together, to read, to pray, to share. We can trust the Lord's promise that we will have eternal life through Jesus Christ. We can trust Him, not me, but Him. The unfailing, this is the last one, the unfailing love of the Lord. Love. Explain this story. Love in Him. If there was no love in Him, nothing would happen. But love never fails. Love never fails. So God loves us so much, since He gave His Son to us so that we can live right with Him. He loved us, the entire world, and He gave His Son. He didn't fail us. He gave His Son. His Son came to save us so we could live. There are many, many verses that are so important for us to know. God's unfailing love. Lamentations 3:22. His compassion never fails. We are still alive because the Lord's faithful love never ends. His compassions never fail. He is faithful. He loves us to the end. In another translation, it says, His mercy never fails. His love and His mercy never fails. And then in Psalms 52:8b, this is the last part of that verse. I will trust God's faithful love forever and ever. Trust Him. He never fails. Another translation, the loving kindness of God. The mercy of God. The faithfulness of God. All these translations, God's love never fails. I will trust God's faithful love through these verses. We trust God's faithful love. Why? In in Psalms 13:5. My heart shall rejoice in your salvation. Psalms 33:22. Our hope is in him. Worship him. God cares about the troubles of our soul. He sees. He isn't blind. He sees the whole world. He sees our souls and our troubles. He sees. He takes care of our soul. We know our bodies will have problems, have health problems. We know we will suffer. But he takes care of our soul, Jesus Christ. God's unspeakable love for you, it continues. It continues, his love continues to be there. Micah 7:18. God delights in showing unfailing love to you. He delights in us. He loves us so much. He first showed us love through Jesus Christ. In the Old Testament and the New Testament, in the heart of God's love, Jesus died and rose again, and we rejoice. And this is very important. True love is God's love for us, not our love for God. He sent, I love God, but he sent his Son as the way to take away our sins. This is 1 John 4:10. He loves us, he showed us. We know God loves us in Jesus Christ. Jesus came and he served and he showed us God. And he died and he rose again. Do you fail to love the Lord? I hope not. No. Most people love the Lord. They love God and Jesus. And they know his love. We have problems every day in our life, but some people fail to do what the Lord wants. He wants us to love him. And if we don't follow him, and if we don't believe in the love of Jesus, that's not his way. We love him. We read. We show our love in reading and praying and coming to worship meetings and sharing with people. Being kind, being joyous. He loves us. He doesn't fail us. All of these, and there's still more. We could add more. The unfailing protection of God. He protects us. His word doesn't fail. There are many more we could add. But this one, the unfailing love of God, is most important. Love is the most important. He loves us so much. And this is from Psalm 73:26 in the New American Standard Bible. My flesh and my heart may fail. I'm weak, I'm human, we're all weak. But God is the strength of my heart and my portion, my soul forever. We have two things, our body, our heart, our mind, it's all weak. We age, we become old, we become weak. Sometimes we can't fix things. But God is strong, and he has our soul. our mind, our soul, forever. Our body will be gone, but our soul will continue. Think about his unfailing love and praise the Lord. Let's sing. Great, high, and holy sing. Thank my soul, raise praise. Who can sing worthy of praise? Wonderful love of Jesus. Wonderful love, wonderful love, wonderful love of Jesus. Wonderful love, wonderful love, wonderful love of Jesus. Joy all day, peace all night. In storms, calm, in darkness, light. In pain, comfort, in weakness, strength. True, wonderful love of Jesus. Wonderful love, wonderful love, wonderful love of Jesus. Wonderful love, wonderful love, wonderful love of Jesus. My hope for forgiveness when I pray, my trust for help when I stray, in life, in death, my all in all, true wonderful love of Jesus. Wonderful love, wonderful love, wonderful love of Jesus. Wonderful love, wonderful love, wonderful love of Jesus. He loves us. He never fails us. If we fail him, what do? We pray and ask forgiveness. This lesson helps us to keep remembering that he never fails us in life. We make mistakes in life. We pray. We ask his forgiveness. We change. He has mercy and kindness to us. Let's pray. Loving Father in heaven, we all thank you for this lesson. It's important to know that you never fail in anything. You are always there to the end. And we can continue to be faithful to you. We praise you, Lord. And we know that you love people. And that you gave your son, Jesus Christ, to save us. We praise you, Lord. Help us when we do wrong and when we fail or give up or downhearted to come back to you, Lord, and forgive us. Help us to do what we need to do to be saved. And we thank you for all your kindness and blessings and love. In Jesus' name, amen. Bless you for your time and listening to God's word. And he loves you, and I love you.